Moemoana captured a nation through the art of Silver Samoa.
I definitely saw the Miss Samoa platform as a platform to directly serve the people. I was born here, so my roots lie here, but I've travelled around the world and I think this was the calling to come back home.
The 24-year-old was crowned Miss Samoa in September last year, 26 years after her mother secured the title. And just like her mother, she went on to win the Miss Pacific Islands crown.
I think in preparation, I definitely reflected on the legacy of my mother, but thinking about how I can pave my own path and share my own stories and messages. I think the Miss Samoa platform now is not just a beauty pageant, and we want it to be something of substance where women are not only seen, but they're heard and they're valued and they can make a contribution to their communities, their villages and their country.
Letau Sala Samoa, or daughter of Samoa, lived in New Zealand and Australia, but remained grounded in her culture by her parents Fred and Mary Jane, founders of Matavai Cultural Arts Centre in Sydney.
That was special to me because my mother's villages are in Savai, so I was able to give back to my family. And Savai is a place where it's still very traditional in terms of Samoa, the Samoan way, and they don't always get the spotlight. I think we always hear the saying, what's good for Upolu is good for Savai.
This passion for her culture comes through, especially on social media, where it's known as the Moemoana effect.
Social media has definitely been a weapon that has helped me promote the initiatives and the programs, the travels overseas to represent the region, but also to raise awareness for things that need to be brought to light, like awareness around climate change, awareness around the political situations in the Pacific.
I saw a glimpse of it. Just you were bombarded. There was a point where people were lining up, queuing to have their photo with you, to just have a part of you. How do you deal with that?
Sometimes I think, who am I to, you know, be looked to as this role model when I'm still myself learning? And I owe it all to Samoa, really. I owe it all to the people for what they've shown me and how they've been able to love on me and support me.
And as she passes on the torch, it's an honour Moemoana will forever cherish.
I hope to do more work in the region and especially in Samoa in service to the things that I'm passionate about. The environment and our culture is central to who we are as Samoans, and that's what I love to share, especially with kids and young people. But I think I've been reminiscing on all of the moments throughout the last year, and they've been a great honour. And it's definitely a time I will never forget, and I hope I can repay the people for the love that they've given me.